Greetings and welcome to a tutorial on how to make a scenario for Mutant Co-op. So, after you get everything set up, as I said on the blog post, you'll have to open up Level Edit, open up Missions, and get the map open. Now, let's open the map. We said we are gonna edit M03. It's loading up. It's done loading. It takes some time before loading. Okay, so we have the map right here. We have a lot of way paths which we can remove, or we can use them for our map. Okay, so before we get started, we have to clean up some mess on the map, like some spawns, some other things. So we get to the instances. Here we have all the stuff, and we go to object, spawner, and here we are gonna remove everything. So all it's removing, and now we are back here. Okay, so now we have to remove the scripts, because they are gonna do some weird things on the map, and we don't want that. So we got now back to the instances, back to object, and to script zone. Now we select all the script zones and we remove them, as we did for the other things. And here for the soldier too, we have to remove all the soldiers because they are not supported in the game, in the multiplayer part of the game. Okay, we removed everything. Now we can get back here and start editing the map. But before we get started, we don't have the spawners. We go to the object and spawner. We don't have the Mutant Cube spawners yet. To do that, let's first save the map right here. Replace that. Let's wait a bit. And now we go to our previous map, and we take this one from M00 tutorial. You can also find it on the blog post. You can find this file, and now we have to place this file right here in the missions. Now we have to reload the map, so we close this and open it again. Before we get started, let's make sure the map doesn't have this file, because this file will override our temps. So let's first remove this one and have only these three files with M03. Now let's load the map again. Let's first not let the sound play again, and we have to wait again. Okay, it's done loading up. So how can you use the camera? This is very important because you have to use the camera a lot. We have two ways to do that: by using the keyboard hotkeys F5 or F6. F6 is for objects and F5 is for the camera. You also can use these buttons up here. This is for the objects. You can now select and move objects around. Or you can use this one to move the camera. Okay, so now we can edit the map. So we have two tabs right here: presets, stuff you can place on the map, and instances, stuff you have on the map. So on the object we can see all the stuff we have on the map right now. We can remove them or not. We can also go to them by double clicking. You can see everything where they are. This stuff is called Days Arrow. You can have cinematics by using this, but they are not working very well on the multiplayer. So you have to make your own by using scripts. Now let's see if our temporary stuff is working. Yep, we have all the temporary stuff. But we are using the M00 tutorial spawners, so still it's not what we wanted. Let's get it from site. You can load it directly from here. But as you can see, it's loading the wrong level editor I have on my computer. I have multiple level editors, so I will still use this one from here. Let's load it up again, and we should have the right presets. We can also add our own presets, but for scenarios you can't have custom models, you can't have custom stuff. So we load it up again, and now let's see if we have the right stuff. Yes, we have the Mutant Cube stuff. We have everything we need, and now we can get started. Now let's see where we should get our players to spawn. On the last scenario, we had the spawn right here. Now let's get it somewhere else. As you can see, you don't always see the things around. This is due to this thing. You have to disable this, and now you can see everything fine. Okay, let's get the player to spawn inside of this, maybe. Yeah, we can block this one. Okay, how we get the players to spawn? So we have to go to presets, spawner, and startup spawners. Let's get the scenario by playing on the node side of the map. Now let's have the node, and GDI will be defending. So now we get node, spawners. We have to place multiple of this. So how you place them? You have to hit make, and then you can just control C and control V to paste them. And now if you hit control Z and you click on him, you can get him high or not. And if you right click, you can rotate him. If you have control Z, you have this one selected. If you don't, you'll get this thing. So you have to get control Z for a correct rotation. You can also hold shift to get up or higher or down. Let's copy more and place. You need to have about 12 to make sure everyone will spawn correctly. Actually, let's rotate all them to the back side, because there will be the purcase terminal. Okay. And now let's place a purcase terminal. How you place that? Now you get to the still here, to the simple CNC objects, and you have PCT zone node, and you make that. It's invisible, and you'll have to find it and click on it and place it where you want it to be. And now you have a purcase terminal right there, and let's make another one right here. There you go. Let's remove this one by hitting delete. Now let's make let's change the theme for GDI, because GDI won't be playable. So how you do that? You first create a GDI spawner. You place it on top or somewhere to be not really hidden, but not accessible by anyone. And here you go to script zone star. It's very important to be script zone star, and you click here. You make this one, and you make it a bit larger. Hold shift to make it bigger, and you need to get the whole shoulder in it. After you get that, you double click it, go to scripts. Make sure you place the scripts, the custom scripts I posted. And now if you get to my crypt. This one. And you set to 0 it's Node and 1 is GDI. You set to 0, team 0, and hit OK. Now GDI won't be playable and only Node will be playable right now. So let's block the door right now because we don't want anyone to get through this door, in or out. So we have some stuff right here that we can use to block the door. Sometimes the levelator is freezing when you copy paste or place new objects. It's something normal, so don't worry, it will not crash yet. You should save often because you never know when it will crash or something. So we have this one set right here. Let's get it a bit. It's perfect. Okay, so we blocked that. Now we have to get these people out of here by teleporting. First, let's get some points where to teleport. So we are thinking, let's have the scenario. Start from the submarine and go to the last beach right there. So let's place some Devoros. So we find them on simple. We have Devoro. Place three of these. Let's get it a bit up because we don't have that collision. So we don't have to worry about the height of the spawners. We have to get the IDs. So we are gonna open notepad and place the IDs right here. We are gonna use the IDs a bit later. So we copy the IDs and place right there. Now we are gonna use the IDs on the teleporter, which will be we are gonna place it right here. So we make a new script zone, a star, hit make. It created right here. Okay, let's place it right here. Make sure it's big enough and it it holds the whole part so they can't get around the script zone. Let's make it a bit smaller right here. And it's perfect. Okay, and let's get the script right now on it. I need to remember. Oh, this one. So this is the script you need to use. Let's place the IDs. You can't use Control V on this, so you have to right click and paste. Okay, now we have the spawners. We can also test the map if you want to. But it should work just fine. So let's get some bots. The thing is, this thing have only bots for NUD, so we need to change them to GDI. So the chain gun bot, we can change it by placing mod on the object we want to change. Player type GDI, spawn max 10 times, spawn delay 10 seconds. And instead of non-minigunner, we are gonna double click it to remove it, and then we have to add our not node but GDI. You have to get the CNC GDI minigunner, and now it should be the right one. Let's check it. Yep. I'm gonna remove this one. Yes. Class Assault. Let's change it. So this is a mutant, so we don't have to worry about it. Just set GDI. And now we have to set the team to 0 to make sure it's a GDI mutant, so he won't attack everyone else. So let's edit this one too. GDI. So we set the team to 0. Actually to 1. I'm sorry. To be GDI. Let's change this one too. Okay. Place it somewhere. It freezes sometimes, it's fine. Okay, now let's get it somewhere in here. We can also, if we hate all this mess around, we can hide them, so we only see the soldiers, but we can't see script zones. So it's kind of bad, but for editing so that it's just fine. Okay, let's put some mutants around here. And you can by accident clicking objects that you can't see. That's weird. See, you can click on topic, so we better get this one back here. Okay, let's now we can spawn the bots, but to do that we need to get the IDs from the bots. This is the most boring part of the whole process, getting the IDs and getting them on the script zone. So we need to place a script zone where the players spawn. So we get here, make a big screw zone here. And now we can get a message here if we want to, like when the player enters this zone. And we need to spawn, to use this one to spawn the bots. So we get ideas here. Like I said, it's the most boring part of the whole process. Get all the ideas. And now if we test the map, we should see the bots spawning. I think I got one of the ideas wrong. Yeah. I need to figure out which one. I think this one. Yeah. That one. Okay. We can also move this one right here, or we can remove it completely or get it high. Nah, let's get it back where it was. Okay, let's save and let's test the map on our local server and see if everything works just fine. Okay, now we get, we just need these two files on our server. Okay. Load the map and let's see if all works just fine. The map loaded up and now we join the game. Okay, loading up. It appears it didn't change our team. We changed the team manually. We can't use this for now because we haven't get the buildings set up. We have to place some buildings. I'll show you in a moment. And well, it doesn't work because we haven't we haven't used the my scripts correctly. So let me fix that. Okay, now it should work just fine. I think it's changing the wrong team. Weird. I think I know why it's doing that. I have a weird setting on my bot. So it was right. Not it's zero. So we save. And now we change, let me change on my bot. See, this is what's going on. Now it's fixed. Just as we planned.
Warning, pulse level critical. Warning, pulse level critical.
Okay, now let's get the building we don't have on the map to get the characters. So you go to buildings, sell the factory, and you place Hand of Nod and also GD Barracks. And to have money, also place the node affinery. Okay. Let's save. Done saving. Let's test it. We can have now the characters. Let me show you a trick right now to change. You can also change the prices on the characters, so you can have a lower price character or a higher price character. To do that, you have to go to global settings, character classes, no, per case settings, because we are on node, we have to change this. To change this, we need to make a temporary, and let's call it node characters mutants. And now we can change the Mendoza to be a higher price, and we can make the minigunner to be, no, not this one, you have to change this one to be a mutant. Why not? So we can get him a mutant. We can do all crazy stuff, but I don't recommend it because you can mess up some stuff. You need to be very careful how you change the stuff. Okay, let's see how it goes. As you can see, Mendoza, it's high price. It costed more. And now this one, yep, it's a mutant. But we don't have weapons. You need to fix that. It's a tricker part, as I said, you can do weird things. But to fix this, for example, you have to go to Soldier, Mutant. Go to the one you changed, and here you have M00 Grant. You also need to do another Grant. Grant power up, and here, for now, we place something random. We find a weapon we want to give to this mutant. So we go to munition, weapon. Actually, we need to use a power up, so not to that, but to power ups. So the power ups, weapon power ups, and we get him Acer chain gun. Actually, you need to make a temporary of this. I had forget to say that for this to work. So we knew we do this. And here we place our new weapon. Make him stronger. But without the skin mutant. This might cause some trouble. So we change that here instead of mutant will be temp. Save. Still saving. Okay, done. See? Much better. So this is how you add the bots and do all sort of things. By using scripts you can do a lot of things, teleporting and all sort of things. You just have to repeat the process and get everything working. Now how you get the level to end, because after beating everyone you have to end the level. There are many ways of ending the level. The most basic one, it's by placing a script zone. So let's get a script zone. And on this script zone, we are going to use this command and do win 0. That means not will win when I get in this zone. You can also set GDI to win, like failure. If you do something wrong, you make the other team win. Okay, let's save and test it. The other way is by using what I mostly use on my maps, the pedestal, where you can place diamond cannon beacons or nuclear beacons. Now when I get to the finish point, the map will end. And the map. We just won the map. Now I recommend you to use a Devourer to show that you made the map. How you do that? Go to simple, click on Devourer, place it somewhere, double click on it, and go to this script. You can name the map you made, like killing GDI. Comes and author your name, and if we save the map and we test it, you'll see it will appear while playing the map. Okay, still saving, it's done. Okay, now you'll see a message showing that who made the map. It should show up in a few seconds. Oh, there you go. So, for now this is all. You can, I hope you make a nice map, and I will make more tutorials for more stuff on Command & Conquer Runegade. I also live stream the making of the map I'm working on for the Mutant Cop. Will be soon showed up. Also, when you'll have to give me the map, please also copy the source of the file. That means also give me this file. You can also give me the whole folder if you want to. That will be much easier for me. And every time you need to test your map, just you have to contact me, and I'll try to set up the server for testing. So thank you for watching. I hope you understand how to make a scenario for this server. Also, beware of these bugs. Okay, damn it. So that was all. Bye bye.